This one promises to be intense. This one all started with Philly's Most Wanted, Black G's and Joker, the Camp Bowie Accent, Called Out Homicide, Low Key, Eddie Kingston, Ricky Reyes, the Challenge 7 Tag Team Action, and Homicide, and Eddie Kingston answered the call. In a cage of death, these two went at each other so physically that they decided to have a singles match in a street fight pool.
I'll tell you what, this is a contest that's got high impact, hard hitting all over. A Joker's on the move. Tope Suicida takes out the last of the dying breed, Eddie Kingston.
When these men were part of Blackout together, the tag team championships were in Blackout, held by these men, and they are possibly the most intense tag team champions in CZW history, but there's been a lot of bad blood since.
And they held those belts for a rather long time, Jake.
That's what happens when you have two men like that as a unit together. That was a unit was dangerous enough. Imagine how dangerous it's going to be now if they're hooking up in a singles match for the first time in CZW.
And Joker, former Best of the Best tournament winner, former Ironman champion Eddie Kingston, former World Heavyweight Champion here at CZW. These two men, very decorated in their past.
And last time out, a cage of death was a rather intense tag team match with the Kings of New York against Philly's Most Wanted. And it ended in a no contest. Referees were laid out. Maven Bentley was laid out. And one of these men tonight could very well end up in the hospital.
Joker able to block that shot attempt by Eddie Kingston. Now Joker now stalking his prey with a head of steam.
Two of the hardest strikers in CZW and two of the most suplex masters of CZW are going at it now.
Oh, not just that one. We're talking CZW.
Oh!
As he just cannonballs into Eddie Kingston, the Cambodian Axe Murderer is in control at this point.
This one's going to be a fight. And I think we've already seen that so far.
Oh, yeah.
A real fight between these two. Joker and Eddie Kingston, the two powerhouses of their tag team, back at Cage of Death. You see the Black Jeans is in Japan right now, repping CZW like he should be. Oh, God.
Can you hear that?
Yes.
Oh, think about all the chops that we've heard echo off the walls here in the Asylum Arena. That one was as hard as Eddie Kingston bringing the pain, and he knows how.
You know, with over 400 events in this arena, I don't know if we're ever going to see a match as wild as this one.
This certainly has been making some classic, and Joker is raining down elbows.
Just listen to those shots. And Joker wants no protection on his arms. There goes his elbow protecting.
Oh, shades of Kawada there. Just kicking him right in the face.
Both these men come from similar backgrounds in wrestling. But the crowd has decided who their favorite is right now. The King of Diamonds, the last of the dying breed, Eddie Kingston, has the crowd support in this one. The fans are jealous for Cambodian Axe Murderer.
Jealous? I just think they plain don't like him. They respect him, but they don't like him.
You are a huge fan of both of these men back in the day. Still a huge fan of their athleticism on the show. Oh, God!
That's unbelievable. The thought from that headbutt. I mean, you're absolutely right, Jake. You know me as well as any. I mean, big time fan of Blackout back in the day, and these two men were two reasons why.
You see, how are these men even still with it after that headbutt? Their heads just collide like two rams.
And look at Joker. Look at the intensity. Not the outcome, the intensity. Ring all over the face of Kingston's face.
Oh, that sets the King of Diamonds down. And Joker knows the street fight rules, what he has to take advantage of. The Cambodian Axe Murderer, the former World Tag Team Champion. It's because of Eddie Kingston's partner at Cage of Death 13 that Joker does not still have that championship.
He's got the heavy artillery out there. Pulled out that table from underneath the ring. He's got bad intentions in mind. Oh, what a headbutt. looking at T-Bone him into there.
But Kingston knew what was coming. He likes to throw his own T-Bone suplexes.
Both of these men suplex machines, hard hitters.
And there's proof of that hard hitting aspect.
Kingston able to put on the brakes. Oh, what's he got?
Oh, God.
Unbelievable.
He didn't put him through the table because he wanted to make sure Kingston landed on his neck with all his body weight.
King fighting his way up to his feet, but found an elbow smash right to the jaw for his troubles, almost for a three count. Joker looking around, asking himself what he has to do.
He knows what he has to do. He's already put that into place, what he wanted to do, but he's having a change of heart.
I think he's just repositioning it.
Well, yeah. Something more
heinous.
Yeah, something more heinous has entered the mind of Joker.
Had a little bit of time to rethink his strategy.
He called the Cambodian action for a reason. We'll have that only if you people promise to stay in the building.
Jake Black now, look at Joker raining down those elbows, the point right to the forehead of Eddie Kingston. And Joker now climbing to the top. But Kingston showing signs of life, kicking him in the face.
Showing some agility. Eddie Kingston cutting off Cambodian Axeburner up top.
And it looks like Kingston has had an epiphany. He sees that table. He sees Joker. He sees destruction as only he knows how to deliver. Superflex through the table, and Joker is feeling it.
The pain etched in the face of the Cambodian Axeburner as he was just driven through that table tells you what you need to know. But Ken, Eddie Kingston capitalized on that high impact superplex off the top rope through the table.
It looks like he hit the back of his head on that table as well.
Yeah, well, it's high risk for a reason. You can protect yourself when the superplex comes down to the canvas, but when you're performing under that table there, it completely throws you off.
Absolutely right, Jake. The first man up to his feet has got to be considered the favorite
win
this contest. It looks like Kingston is going to have that advantage. He's up in a seated position, but look at Joker. He's almost up to both knees. He's on all fours at this point. Both men on both fours. On all fours, rather. Both in a kneeling position. Eddie Kingston looks like he's going to dish out the first strike, and there it is, an elbow right to the jaw. Joker, not to be outdone, returns in favor. These two men, these two warriors, gladiators, just trading shots right here in the middle of the Asylum Arena, just like they have done time and time again. Listen to these shots.
This is our contest to see who has a bigger one between these two. Neither of these men must be outdone by the other. Roaring elbow by Kingston. The former CCW World Champion is on his feet, but the former Tag Team Champion, the Cambodian Axeburner, sets him down again. Reverse capture the suplex.
What impact on that, too.
And you see the ring has been ripped open by these two.
Shining Wizard nearly knocked Kingston out.
But Kingston still able to kick out, showing why he's a former World Heavyweight Champion in CZW.
Eddie Kingston holding that fist high in the air, showing everybody here in the Asylum Arena that he is still with it, he is still conscious, he's still able to keep fighting. Use it, spinning back fist right to the jaw choker. High impact Saito suplex.
And now we see Kingston.
Sliding knee to the back of the head. Kingston hooks the leg. This could be it for Joker. But he gets that right shoulder up.
And we see Kingston just hit three of his big offensive moves. And that might have been it. That might have been the fourth. The nail in the coffin. And Joker's out.
The death.